All right, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a really nice, simple slideshow video, especially for my students who have to create a visual story. So the first thing that I want you to do before you go to Adobe Spark is you're going to, on your computer, organize your images. So here I have a whole bunch of images of my dogs that I pulled together to use as an example. And you can see that I numbered these. I added numbers so that I have number one, number two, three, four, and five ready to go right here in this folder. All right, so that's the first thing I want you to do is you're going to make sure your images are edited and ready and in order so that when you put together this slideshow, you don't have to worry about that. So this is the homepage for Adobe Spark, and you don't have to sign in or pay for anything. You go right over here, start for free. I'm going to click on that little button, and the first thing it does is it asks for a title. So I'm going to call my story something. I am going to call it Going for a Walk. And you can skip this, and at this point, like, it will create, when I download a file that is titled Going for a Walk. If I skip it, it will create a file that says Adobe Spark Video. So either way, it's okay. The next thing, it's going to give you all of these templates, and I'm going to tell you to skip these templates and start from scratch. We don't need no stinking templates. And I want you to keep this simple. So you could watch a video here with some quick tips for getting started, but I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to say, okay, I'm ready. And here now it puts me on the page where I will create my video. So the first thing I'm going to show you how to do is these are slides down here. And I'm going to start with one, the first slide, the layout for it. We're going to just add a title. And we're not going to put a video or a photo on this. We're going to keep it really simple. So that title is Going for a Walk. I could put my name here. Make sure I type my name correctly. And I am going to also add more slides. So down here we can see this is credits. This is my title, and I want five slides, one for each image in my visual story. So I'm just going to hit this little plus button here. One, two, three, four, five. And now I'm ready to start adding things. So I'm just going to slide this back over here. This is my title slide. And this is just where I'm going to start adding my photos. So I've clicked here. I'm just going to rapidly put my photos in. Come over here, upload photo. I've been playing with Spark, so I don't have to go hunting for the folder here. But now, conveniently, my first photo was right here, number one. I double click on that. And this is what it looks like when it's loading the photo, that little round and round thing going on here. So the first thing I want you to notice is that this is cropped. For my students especially, I don't want anything cropped except how you cropped it. So I clicked on this little pencil icon that gives me some editing, very simple editing options, making it bigger or smaller. I want to zoom out. until I see the edges of that photo. So now I know that this is how I cropped this image. Another thing I want you to see is the time of the slide is set for 2 seconds. That is super fast. It will not give anybody much of any time to see that image. So 10 seconds is a decent enough amount of time, not too long for that slide. Also, I want to check on here if I click here. So this is only 4 seconds, and that's probably sufficient, but I could also make it a little bit longer. So this is number one. I'm just going to real quickly add all of the photos in here so you can see literally how easy and fast this works. And you can see I'm getting to see what's going on down here. Uploading the image is indeed probably the slowest thing. So again, I'm going to reduce the size until I see the whole thing. There we go. I get that little tiny blue strip. I'm going to make sure that the time is 10 seconds. And I'm going to move to my next slide. And I'm going to add my next photograph, which is conveniently in order. See how that works. And I can change my time while my photo is uploading, so I can do multiple things at once. And again, bring out my photo so you can see it all, oops, the edges, and I can go back. See how that works? All right, and so that was number three. Adding a photo, uploading it. Number four. If you hear funny noises in the background, that is the same dogs getting goofy, because they are with me pretty much all the time. All right, and then finally, photo number five. And this is not a super sophisticated story. This is more to show you how to make the story in the video. Okay, now this doesn't want to cooperate with me. All right, we'll minus this out. And there we go. Interesting. It didn't want to do, there it goes. All right, and so finally I have my credit slide, and so if I click on here, this is just my title again, and this is where I would put my name, because these are my images. And again, I might add a little bit of time. Okay, so couple more things. Now I've got my whole video here, and before I start to preview it, I want to go over here to the theme. And for my students, this kind of really bright colored thing is a little distracting. Thankfully, I can use several different themes, and I have options within the themes. So if you like a little bit of color, you can switch it around. So now I have a nice white background. My title slide has a little bit of color. And as I move through, then it looks more lovely. I also have an option that is not quite black. It's a navy-ish color, and again, this is a better than the bright colors. I can change the colors of the words as well. I really like this theme. Elevate, again, I can change to a more neutral background and a dark background. So my students need to stay with something more neutral, white, black, gray. We can see how when we have these bright colors, it can be a little, it doesn't feel professional. Let's just say that. How much more professional this feels. Okay, the one theme I don't want you to use is flare, because it turns your photograph color. Even if you use a white background, it's not really white. So do not use flare. Noir is classic and lovely, no matter what. Nice gray. So there are more options. Always, always choose something more neutral. Even this is more neutral and acceptable. Sage also, as a theme, has more neutral, more professional looking options, whether it goes dark or light or black. Grace is another one that has subtle color options. Not so much. But the black or the white, much better. Also, I think there's a gray option here. We can see that. Okay, so those are the kinds of things I want you to think about for that. As far as resizing goes, I want my students to keep it on widescreen, not square. And then music. So there are many different choices here for music. You can listen to the music. A stroll in Central Park, that might be appropriate. You can also add your own music, but be aware that we're looking at a very short, that's funny, my preview hasn't caught up, a very short overall time here. So at 10 seconds a slide, we're in the vicinity of about 1 minute. And when I feel like I have everything the way I want it, then I am going to actually preview. So let's see, by clicking on this preview button, what this looks like. So we have a nice... Oh, I didn't actually click on the different sound. So this is one of the reasons you want to preview. This has given me a different music track than I thought I was getting. So if I want to change something, I can go back. I can just stop it here. I can go, no, I want to actually get my stroll in Central Park music. And I want to have a black background, and now I'm going to preview it again, and it starts over. There we go. And this is where I can see my final time is 1:03, which is perfect. So this would be the point I would want my students to double check that they have started with a title slide, that each image is up for about 10 seconds, that you've got the color appropriate for the background, and that the music feels right, and wait for it. We'll be looking to make sure that I didn't mess up on the credits. Hey! Alright, so now that I've got everything the way I want, I'm going to click download. This is going to take a little bit of time. You can see I've got my progress up here, and it warns me that closing this window will cancel the download. It's pretty simple though. And when it's done, I will have an MP4 file in my download folder in my computer that has the title Going for a Walk. And it will be this lovely little 1 minute video. And that's pretty much it. You can see it takes a little bit of time. Depending on your internet connection. Almost there, almost there. Oh my gosh. They at least give you cute little things to read while you're waiting. But this is something that you can make a little video of all kinds of things. You can even put actual video clips in here. But for this, for my students, for their final project, your visual story, I want you to keep it simple. And I am looking forward to seeing what your visual stories look like. We're almost there. We're almost there. Getting so close. All right. I think we're just about there. This is called real time, so you can see how it works. Okay, almost. Almost. Wow. It's suspenseful. Ta-da! And so this is where it is, going for a walk. I can save my file. Okay. And that's how you make and how fast you can make a video slideshow on Adobe Spark.